Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about SP3 hybridization, SP2 hybridization, and now we are moving with the topic that is SP hybridization. So what is SP hybridization and how does the bond forms and how does it helps to form a bond with a particular orientation, or we could say with a symmetry? And let us talk about that thing with the help of an example, but let us understand what is SP hybridization. So now let us understand what is SP hybridization. So talking about the definition first, there is the process of mixing and recasting of, that is, 1s and 1p orbital of the same atom with nearly equal energy to form basically 2 sp hybrid orbitals, that is what I want to talk about. And as we have discussed earlier also, that is the hybrid orbitals that have been formed, they will have basically equivalent energy and with maximum symmetry, and we could say with a definite orientation in space. So that is how the hybrid orbitals plays a very vital role. And since we are talking about the mixing of 1s and 1p orbital, so obviously they will form the equivalent number of the hybrid orbitals, and that is 2 hybrid orbitals, and they will form a basically symmetrical molecule, and we could say that they will have a proper orientation, bond angle, and spacing bond angle. So now let us talk about the example first. So talking about the SP hybridization, so a molecule just like that of we have considered like methane, ethene, and now we are considering about ethyne. So now here we are going to talk about formation of ethane. So here formation of ethane, that is what I want to talk about. That is ethane structure, that is we know already, that is, it is the one which consists of basically 2 carbon atoms and that is 2 hydrogen atoms. But talking about the next thing that I am going to talk about, that it consists of basically 3 bonds between carbon and carbon. So this blue lines that I have made it over here, these are the pi bonds, while the talking about the green bond that I have made over here, that is basically the sigma bond. And that basically just as to showcase that they are 2 are different. So that's why I have mentioned it that way. So now let us come back to the main thing that I am going to talk about. So if I'm talking about the atom that has been forming or that is giving us a hybrid orbital, and in this case similar to that of ethene that we have discussed in our previous lecture, so that is, this one is carbon number A, suppose if I'm giving, and this is carbon number B, and suppose this carbon number A is the one which is undergoing hybridization. So obviously we should understand that what is the electronic configuration of that carbon, and because of we know that the orbitals are responsible for mixing and giving a particular that is hybrid orbital. So let us understand that one. So for that, I'm talking about carbon number A. So just mentioning over here, with which we know that is carbon has an electron configuration of that is 1s2, 2s2, and 2p2. So if I bifurcate it, or if I make it in a specific manner, that what kind of orbitals are present over here. So now this is the 2s orbital. I'm just naming it as because it consists of only one orbital. I'm talking about the p shell or p subshell. That is, it consists of 3 orbitals. So that is what I mentioned over here. But if you look that it consists of basically 2 electrons over here in 1s orbital, while that of the p subshell consists of 2 electrons, and each orbital consists of 1 electron. So this is what I have mentioned over here. And talking about that is the bond that have been formed. Obviously we could see that the carbon actually is forming bond with 2 atoms, and those are basically hydrogen and carbon. While talking about this one also, again it is forming that is bond between 2 atoms, that is hydrogen and carbon. So is it the valency that is correct over here? Actually we have to hybridize it also, because as we could see there is presence of that is carbon carbon triple bond over here, and that's the reason that obviously when methane was being when we have discussed about methane, even the carbon was undergoing excitation, the electrons were been exciting, and we made a particular hybrid orbitals. And that of we have also discussed about that is in ethene, we have basically we have excited the electron, and in that also basically one of the unhybrid orbitals was been there. And similarly, we are going to discuss about here also. Obviously, now we have to excite this electron. So the electron that has been present over here is basically of ground state. So I'm just naming it like GS, that is ground state, and for which we have to excite it. So I'm just exciting the electron by providing particular kind of energy. So what will happen is one of the electrons that are basically a paired electron, or I would say, or coupled electron. So now they will decouple and one of the electrons will be shifted to the pz orbital. So here let me explain or let me specify that this is px orbital, this is py orbital, and they all are of the second shell. So I could say like 2px orbital, 2py orbital, and so on. And this is the s orbital. So now the main thing is we have to excite the electron, and that's what I want to do. So in this case, suppose what I'm doing is I'm just shifting this electron, or I'm just exciting this electron on the pz orbital. So this is what I have mentioned in a black one. Meanwhile, the rest of it will remain the same. So that's it. So this is what we have, but this is not what we have come to the conclusion, because this is what we have excited the electron, or we have followed the first step of hybridization. The next step is basically mixing of orbitals. So let us understand that how can they be mixed, and which kind of orbital it will be formed. So let me talk about this one. That is, since we are talking about sp hybridization, so even this the carbon which gives carbon-carbon triple bond, they usually gives sp hybridization. And in this case, basically we need only two orbitals so that they would mix with each other and to form basically hybrid orbitals. So in that case, basically if I specify that this one is the s, this one is px, py, pz, so among this thing, basically one s, it will be confirmed, it will be involved, and among this one orbital of p will be involved in mixing of the atomic orbitals, and so as to form a hybrid orbital. So let me talk about it this way, that whenever the mixing will happen, so this is what I'm talking about. So this mixing, basically the two s orbitals, that is what I'm mentioning over here. So this 2s orbital will combine with that of one of the that is, I'll write it over here as one of the basically px orbital, suppose. So after mixing, what happens is these two get mixed with each other so as to form basically, I would say, like hybrid orbitals. So this is the 2sp hybrid orbital, even this is the 2sp hybrid orbital, and now they are basically, we could call it as hybrid orbitals. While the rest of these two, they will remain unhybrid. So I'm just making it sure that these two are basically 2py and 2pz, they are basically, I would say, like unhybrid orbitals. So now this is how I am going to talk about, and so this is the mixing that we have did, and recasting also, it is the same thing. Almost when basically we have casted it, basically out of which that which one is to be basically responsible for formation of a that is hybrid orbital. So even that is what we have did over here. And now the main thing is what would be the structure of this one, or what would be the orientation of this kind of atomic orbital. So that is what I want to explain to you. So now what we have is we have basically two sp orbitals. So this is one sp orbital, and that is hybrid orbital, and again this is also the sp hybrid orbital. So these are the two sp hybrid orbitals that we have, and these are the two unhybrid p orbitals, we could say in that manner also. So what is the orientation, what is the structure of that? Let me talk about this one. So since the structure of basically the sp hybrid orbitals, and since we have two sp hybrid orbitals, so that's the reason that we could get the structure in this manner. So I just made an just to showcase that these are the two hybrid, that is, or I could say like sp hybrid orbital. And similarly, this one is also basically sp hybrid orbital. So basically, this is geometry of it. So in the previous lecture that we have discussed about, that is sp3 hybridization. So s is the one is spherical, p is of x axis, y axis, z axis, that we have discussed about, and they were of that is double shape. But while mixing, and while they were forming the hybrid sp3 hybrid orbitals, 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals, but the structure of that was changed from that is a spherical or from double shape to basically tetrahedral shape. So that happened because of the mixing. And similarly, we have discussed about in sp2 hybridization also, because in that case also, the expected was like we could have got sp3 hybridized, but actually it was sp2 hybridized and the structure was basically trigonal planar. But here also the structure is, this is what we have got about the sp hybrid orbitals, and now this is basically linear. So obviously whether it is linear, it is on the plane, or we could say it anyway. So this is a structure that we have got over here. But talking about the two unhybrid orbitals, that is this one I am talking about. This is the two unhybrid orbitals that I am talking about, that is py and pz. So even they will be present, and talking about in this manner, that is as we know that py and pz, they are mutually perpendicular to each other. So meanwhile, this is somewhere acting like px, py, pz, so they all are mixing. So somewhere it looks like that way. But let me talk about this thing only, that we should only consider that is sp hybrid orbitals for now, because it is main responsible for giving the structure, for giving the geometry, for giving the orientation. Everything is responsible because of the sp hybrid orbitals that we have, and that is the unpaired electrons, or we could say like the unhybrid pz orbitals as well as py orbitals. They don't give a specific that is role in giving the geometry or in giving the shape to the molecule. So let me explain that also, that they will be remaining in the orbital, but they won't be responsible for mixing. So suppose this is the one which is I'm just explaining about, like py, and there would be another one that is basically pz, that would be mutually perpendicular. So let me explain it in this way. So this is pz, and this two both are basically unhybrid. So we'll consider this also, that is this two, but for now let us consider this one. So let me give the structure of the ethane, that how it has been formed. So even if I draw it again, then I will get to know that is this is the structure of the sp hybrid orbital of that is the carbon A sp hybrid orbital. So these are the two sp hybrid orbitals, and obviously this end which is basically sp, I would write it over here, that is sp hybrid orbital. So now this will be the one that will be combined with that of the hydrogen. So this hydrogen, that is I'm talking about this hydrogen. So now obviously the s orbital of hydrogen, that is of spherical shape, and s orbital of hydrogen can combine with any of the that is orbital, atomic orbital or hybrid orbital also, so as to form a sigma bond. So obviously this is the s orbital of hydrogen over here, and obviously there will be coupling of electrons. One electron will be of the sp hybrid orbital, while the one electron will be of hydrogen, and they will combine with each other, and or they will overlap with each other. That is what I want to talk about. So this is a carbon number A that I was talking about, and similarly we can make this for carbon number carbon B also. So let me explain it with this green one, just as to bifurcate that two carbons are present in it. So suppose this is basically, again this is what I am showcasing about basically sp hybrid orbital of that is carbon B. Suppose again that carbon B, that is what I am talking about here, is this carbon B is the one that has been combined with this of hydrogen. So now here I could write it in this way, that is this sp hybrid orbital of the carbon, it will combine with that of the hydrogen, and again there will be coupling over here, because one hydrogen, one electron is of the hydrogen, while the one electron is the electron of carbon, and based on that is sp hybrid orbital. So this is how, where we could see that sigma bond has been formed. So I will write it over here as sigma bond, and here also because of the two hybrid orbitals, that is they have overlap with each other actually, so again there will be a bond formation, and again this one would be a sigma bond. But we are forgetting something. Yes, I hope you have got to know. Yes, that is basically py and pz unhybrid orbitals. So they are basically, I would write it over here in this way, because this is the thing that we have got. And see, we could say that the bond angle, we could see earlier only, that is the bond angle that we have got is basically 180, because it is the linear geometry that we have got over here. But let me talk about that is the unhybrid orbitals also. So suppose if this is the py, and let me take it with this one also, that is suppose if this is the pz orbital, and this both are basically unhybrid orbitals. Again for carbon B also it will be remain the same, that is py orbitals that will remain that is unhybrid, and pz orbital. that will leave me an hybrid. So obviously in both the cases, suppose if I'm talking about that is a PY orbital. So let me talk about PY orbital first. So here you could see a PY orbital over here, and here also you could see PY orbital over here. So suppose they are present in this form, obviously they are present in parallel way. So obviously when they will overlap with each other, they will overlap laterally. And that's the reason that the interaction between the PY and the PY here over here, as you could see. So that's why PY and PY orbitals that are basically unhybrid, they will overlap that is laterally, and that's the reason that there will be formation of that is pi bond, and that is what I'm showcasing over here. But talking about PZ orbital, because PZ orbital, it will be in the x-axis, because we are talking about especially about the PZ orbital, and suppose that is present in this one, that is, this is PZ orbital, and this is the PZ orbital of the carbon number B. And now they are, now again they will overlap, that is in this way, or I could say like they are overlapping laterally. So suppose if this is the one that is present in z-axis, and again this is the PZ that is present in the z-axis, suppose in that orientation. So now they will combine with each other, or they will interact with each other laterally. So that is what I want to showcase, just like that of PY and PY. So now the interaction will let us to understand that there will be a formation of pi bonds, and that is the reason that the pi bond that has been formed, it is because of the lateral overlapping of that is PY orbitals of the both the carbon and PZ orbitals of the both the carbon, and that is how two that is pi orbitals are been formed. That is two pi bond is been formed, and this is what I wanted to showcase. So let me just give a geometry that what it looks like. So this is the one which is very much similar to understand. So this is the carbon atom which has formed that is sigma bond with that of the hydrogen atom, sigma bond with that of the carbon atom, that is carbon B. This is sigma atom sigma bond due to the bond formation with that of the hydrogen atom, because of the obviously we know because of that is coaxial overlapping of the atomic orbitals or hybrid orbitals, you could say. And now the main thing, this is the pi bond that has because of PY unhybrid orbitals of both, and now this is the one which is responsible again for pi bond, which is because of the PZ unhybrid orbitals of both the carbon atom, and this is how we could find the structure of the ethylene. And let me conclude it with that is the bond angle. So it is a linear shape that we know, so I would write it over here as a linear shape, and the bond angle that we have got to know, it is because of it is a linear shape, the bond angle is basically 180 degrees. So this was an example that I want to talk about, very easy. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know that what is hybridization and what are the role of hybridization that I was speaking continuously in my previous lectures. So I hope you have got this one. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got this video very clearly, and you share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.